Okay, here we go. Everyone, welcome to Kailul Shira. And well, we're still in Hilchas Beis HaKnesses. And we're on page Reish Lamed Hey. And we're going to start with letter Zion. Okay?
Okay.
V'al Kain. Mikav Elucha, right? V'al Kain. Amar Rabbi Sein Azal. Beautiful, beautiful words. Asidin kol batei kinesias sheyalu l'Yerushalayim. Beautiful words in Chazal, in Masechta Megillah, that it's going to be in the Yemais HaMashiach, all the Batei Knesias from all around the world, in all of the Yeshuvim from all around the world, they're going to make their way back to Yerushalayim. And we said last week that what? All the Kedusha stems from Yerushalayim. Yerushalayim is the headquarters of all Kedusha in the world. And all the Batei Knesias get their Kedusha from Yerushalayim. So it's so apropos that all of those Batei Knesias from all around the world will make their way back to Yerushalayim, their headquarters. Through the Kedusha of the Beis HaKnesses via us, in all the Jews in their shuls, holding the shul and sanctifying the shul and keeping it in a way of Kedusha. And the yira that they did, and the fear that they have when they walk into the shul that they'll act in a proper and appropriate way. So then, all of the artsias, all of the physical things, all of the earth, everything around it is mevatel. Val kain meachas shesham nispatel artsias bevada yuchal alis bimakam mekaymelushlaim. So look at this, look at this. It's amazing what this was saying here. It's the pshat of how is it going to work that all the batik and the siyas are going to come back to Yerushalayim? Because what is dividing, what divides one building from the next? The land in between it. But if you take away all the land in between it, so then there's no, it's there. Let's do it one more time. You have a building and another building. Now, if you take the space, the land in between it away, now the buildings are together. So if you mevatel all the artsias around the world, things that are not physical, and only the shuls remain, so the shuls of Mela will make it back to Yerushalayim.
Can they be attached to each other?
We'll have some understanding. But the artsias, the physicality, the land around it will be nullified. So then the buildings can, the Mela, they can go be wherever they have to be.
Let's find out.
The main distance and the separation between one building and one place and the next is what? No problem. In other words, you build a building, and then this is the property line of this building, and that's the property line of that one, and so on. Ki artzi is nice and gevul, because the land itself gives the boundary, the border, the land. And that's what differentiates one place to the next. Aval kitchnis batal artzi is voisim shalom. But when you mevatal the artzi is, and we said we learned a couple of weeks ago, just chazar a little bit, that what anytime we conquer, we want to build a shul. So the Umas HaOlam, they're not necessarily happy that we want to make a shul, right? Because what are you doing? You're bringing it onto your side. This is you're in our country. Why are you making a shul here? The Umas HaOlam are not necessarily happy when we build religious institutions.
Why?
Because we go against our principles are very different than theirs. We're very different than the Umas HaOlam, are we not? Right? Yeah. And yes, go ahead. Yes.
Many of them recognize that they are wrong.
Well,
because when the God is,
we help them recognize it.
When the gardeners come around my block, they say, "You're the chosen people. You're the right ones."
Yeah.
But I mean, they
got it. Some of them get it. Very few, but some of them do. Okay, now, Now, when you're mavatel the artsy is the different the spaces in between, so then you'll wind up with shalom. He explains, as I call echad, because then everything becomes unified one. In other words, your property is here and his property is here, but if you put the properties together, now we're together. We don't have separation. We're together. Maybe we can understand it like this. You can have single family homes, and then you can have a townhouse. Townhouses. So what are townhouses? They're all connected. So if you separate the townhouses, you'd have separate properties. Right? But now, what's a townhouse? They're all built together. Ki ein hafsek ugvul bein Yerushalayim la beis haknesses, because there's no real difference between Yerushalayim, the land in Yerushalayim, and any Beis HaKnesses anywhere around the world. Me'achashin is batel kol ha'atzias, when all of the atzias, the land will leave in between it, and the shuls will be part of you, become part of Yerushalayim. Val kein bevada yalu kol ha'makom eskadashim shein Beis HaKnesses Yerushalayim, ki ruchnius, einai teifis makom. Ruchnius, when you have spirituality, doesn't take up any space. Spirituality does not take up space. A building takes up space, but a spirituality does not. Ruchnius does not take up any space. Aval ze yielosit kishiyushleim habeira beshleimus, when the clarification and it will be bishleimus ki eina kedusha nishlam bishleimus ad lasid lavei she is kayev amdu ragla bayoimahu al har hazesim. We're waiting for that day that all of the tzaddikim that are buried on har hazesim, they can all stand up amdu ragla al har hazesim. Vaz yia nishlam kedusha sabes haknesses bishleimus ad shiyalu kulam yushalayim. All of the tzaddikim will come back alive, b'tchias ha-mesim, and all the batei kenesias and all the places will all come together. There'll be a beautiful unity that the world is lacking at this time. Ki ha-artzias yisbatel mehem ligamrei oz, because the artzias, the land, is the bitel right now. V'chein mevayisham v'pasik who gufei v'omdu ragla b'yoyim hu al har hazesim v'nivka chatzi ahar. What does baka mean? They'll split.
What's the legame oz?
Completely. Right. V'omdu ragla b'yoyim hu al har hazesim v'nivka. What does baka mean? Nivka. To split, right? By keiayam lefnei Moshe, right? By keiayam, to split. Right? Yeah. V'chatzi ahar. Nimsa shemivayisham sheyia oz nisim gedolim beinyan b'kia sahar. There'll be great miracles where the mountain will, the har hazesim will actually split. Sheyagiyo aharim ze lazeh. The mountains will come one to another. Shekasu sham ki yagiyo. Next page, please. Keharim el Eitzel. All the mountains, all the other holy mountains will come together. Ayin Shem Perish Rashi. Rashi says like this. V'chol ze yiyah machmas goydol shleimus ha-kedusha sheyiyah oz kishiyushleim beirer ha-raglin shezeo b'chinas v'amdu raglov. In other words, at that time, when everyone will come alive and the lands will all come together and all the batei kenesias will make their way back to Yerushalayim. Until the mountains can come one to another, the batei kenesias can come one to another. And therefore all the batei kenesias will come to Yerushalayim. Again, Rav Nasa is just helping us understand what does it mean when the Gemara Megillah says that in the time of Maisa Mashiach, all of the batei kenesias will make their way to Yerushalayim. So he's explaining that physically, what happens is there's the spaces in between the lands and the countries and the places. If all of that is being mevatel, it's nullified. So then the Beis HaKnesset, there's no space in between. It kind of just moves its way up to Yerushalayim. If everything besides the holiness is in the world, so we're saying that ruchnius doesn't take up any space, but physicality does. But if you mavatel this physicality, the space is in between. So mele the batekinesias can all make their way back, and just advance to Yerushalayim. What's dividing Yerushalayim now from let's say the shuls here in New York and anywhere else? There's an ocean, there's land, there's this. But if you mavatel all of it, if you take away the ocean, so then you move the shul that much closer. And if you take away all the other lands, it comes that much closer.
Yeah. A lot of ocean.
What? There's a lot of ocean, right? Yeah.
Oh,
yeah, sure, there's a lot of ocean. Kikishin is bat, lina artsi is, because when you nullify the land, yichaylim kalam makaymais, harachaykim liskarev ulischaber yachad. So all the distant places can now come and join together. Can now all join together because you took away the boundary, the borders that were in between each place. Does this make it, it's a little far-fetched, right?
Yeah. But how about the buildings? I mean, forget about the land, but how about the buildings there?
The buildings no. Right? So look. If you understand like this, if you have a house and a house, mm-hmm. and let's say there's a mile of land in between the one house to the next house. So if you take away, if you so to say got rid of that mile of land in between the two houses, now these two houses are together.
He says not all houses are houses of worship.
Right. So they'll be mevatel. So then those will be mevatel. That's bittel. That's all. Well, yes, it's not. It's useless.
Those houses of non-worship.
Useless.
What's going to happen to those houses of non-worship? Are they going to be destroyed?
Well, I guess you're going to have to stay tuned and find out.
Where are you going?
We're talking now. Okay, Ernie. We're talking now about shuls.
The shuls. Yeah.
We're talking about batei kenesias. Okay, that's the topic, that's the theme that we're discussing now. And the Gemara doesn't say anything over there about houses. The Gemara mentions about batei kenesias.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Okay, I mean, the Sfarim all do say that every Jewish home is also a little like a mikdash ma'at, and this, and then they also can
what
come.
What does it say if you got a shul next to a church?
Yeah.
But the church is useless. It's going to be bittel. It'll be bittel. It won't be there. You're always going to have a shul next to it. Look. When you know that people think that if a shul, the church opens next to a shul, it's a terrible sign. But I always think differently. It's a terrible sign. Why did the church open next to a shul? But I always think differently. It's zeh. In other words, everything in the world is always balanced. So if you have a shul that's really full of kedusha and they're doing the right thing, and the church opens up, that means it's the best news for you to tell you that you're doing the right thing, because the other side opens up right next to you. Okay, I'm sorry. Okay. Okay. Now, b'zeh, kama gavizah chagim l'schaber yachad. B'zeh b'chines gaydel ha-shalom she'yihaz, and that'll be the great shalom that'll be at that time. Because shalom, when you have peace, you have unity. You have unity and connection. You have connection. Right now, everything is disparaged. It's spread out. But when the Yemaisa Mashiach, everything's going to come closer together. That's what shalom is. When there's achdus, unity, and this connect and this closeness. He is batel artsi is because when you mevatel, when you nullify the lands, shehu masach hamavdel, that is what is dividing it at the present moment. V'yalu v'yischabru kol hakedushas, and all of the holiness will go up and it will be connected. Yachad v'chinas shalom, and that'll be shalom. So look, that's a beautiful idea to understand the concept, just to understand the concept of how can we possibly understand that all of the shuls are going to be in Eretz Yisrael. So if nothing's explained to us, that the land that's dividing in between will be nullified, so the mele, the shul, will be over there. In other words, the land of the shul itself, we learned, has the kedusha of Eretz Yisrael. Because it's stemming from, it gets its kedusha from Eretz Yisrael. right? Yerushalayim is the source of the headquarters, right? We said, of all Kedusha, right? So now all shuls that are doing the right thing and following Shulchan Aruch, and the Jews are coming to the shul and they're learning and they have Yiras Hashem in the shul. So then these are all shuls that have part and parcel to the holiness of Eretz Yisrael.
And the land within those
shows. And the land within the shows. So now, all the land that's next to it, that's dividing it, is bimavatel. So the mail of the shul will just advance over to where it has to go.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Okay, interesting. Right. It's an interesting concept, right? Right. Everyone agrees that's a very interesting concept. But can anyone suggest another idea of how the shuls will magically just arrive in Yerushalayim?
The land will stretch.
But so you're saying so it doesn't have to stretch. Why does it have to stretch?
There's another way.
So you're suggesting that the shuls will actually be picked up and they'll be placed in another place in Eretz Yisrael.
Transplanted.
Okay, so we're saying here that the shul will not be transplanted, but the land itself that the shul sits on is going to, that itself will be part of Eretz Yisrael. It's fascinating. Okay. Anyway, so that's that section over there. And now we're going to see, let's look at letter A. Ches, okay?
Go ahead.
What was
the other alternative? Is there another alternative other than... The land.
He suggested that possibly the shul, the land of Eretz Yisrael, will be stretched, and then the shuls will be picked up and retransplanted over there.
Transplanted where?
In Yerushalayim.
Okay.
One second. We're not really saying very different. Where's the other land going to come from? The land is going to be this land.
No problem.
I understand. But so Reb Nosson explains the Metzias that it will. You're right. It'll definitely expand, but it'll be the land itself that the shul is sitting on. That'll then become part of the land of Eretz of Yerushalayim.
Okay.
Does it make it interesting? A concept, right? Yeah. Go ahead, Yaakov.
Does he mean the land?
Both.
Or does he mean the substance? In other words, when he says that the shuls will be... What is a shul? A shul is a building. It gets its kedusha from the people who learn and pray there.
Connected to Yerushalayim.
Yeah. Connected to... So when the Jews take them, remove themselves to Yerushalayim...
Mm-hmm. So you're saying the shuls just go with them?
The congregations go. And maybe that when you say the Bate Knessios and the Bate Midrashos, that's the... Because of the people, so the people will come in groups, as in other words, group from Young Israel Woodmere, Young Israel West Hempstead, Chabad someplace. As groups, they will be transported to Israel. The distance is only a physical distance. Spiritually, we are connected. We have this connection, and then when it transfers, maybe we don't need to have the buildings. The buildings are sold, and they'll take the money to build new ones.
But we're saying that the buildings themselves have Kedusha in the building itself.
This building here,
that's right. So notice, we're sitting in the class in the base medrash here, right? Mm-hmm. And in Emetz Hashem, this building with us in it will travel and make its way to Eretz Yisrael. We wouldn't have to go through the security line at the airport. We don't have to sit on the plane and worry about this and that. And where you're going to sit in the window? This, you sit in a nice seat, and then the base of Knesset will just make its way there to life. And then we'll walk outside and we'll see. They'll say shalom lecha chaver.
Is it possible that we redeem the value of the building?
I don't know. That's not that, but that's not what we're learning over here.
Okay, I know that.
No, no, but again, what did the Gemara Megillah say? We're using that as to draw this lesson that the Batei Knessios will make their way to Eretz Yisrael. Do you remember what it said? Should we read it one more time? Let's just revisit it one more time. The statement. Now that we learned the concept, Asidin, kol Batei Knessios sheyalu liYerushalayim, sheyalu, that they will elevate and they will make their way to Yerushalayim. That's what the Gemara says.
The fact The fact that they're going to...
So you're suggesting that maybe, you're suggesting maybe the money, you'll take the money in your pocket and you'll try, go to the shul, and you'll build a new shul. I don't know. That's not what the Gemara says.
But when you say Sheya'alu, in other words, going to Israel...
Sheya'alu. Sheya'alu. They will elevate, they will go up.
The fact that the people come to the Israel,
they call that Aliyah.
Aliyah.
Okay, so, yes. So. Okay. All right, okay. Let's go by.
You say the people are coming, not the building itself.
The people have to come. The buildings are not going to come without the people.
Well, yeah, with a building without people is useless. Right. Okay, let's go by. Okay, now. And we learned this concept that we always go up in Kedusha, but we don't go down, right? So we learned if you have a bima, and if you have the parochis, you could buy a thing for the Sefer Torah. And if you sold this, you could buy. Right? Remember we had that lesson. Remember? Okay. V'ikatachlas hakedusha hu kedusha Sefer Torah. But the highest level of kedusha is what? The Sefer Torah. The Sefer Torah. Kamur b'mishnah b'shulchan aruch b'nei ayia shemachru. Right, in Aruch Chaim, and it discusses if you sold different things, what you can use the money. What you can use the money for, okay? Now, machru beis haknesses loichim, okay. Ad shemachru svarim, if they sold different svarim, they sold different books, right? They sold sederim chamash and they sold svarim, right? What can they do? They can buy, use their money to buy sefer Torah. Yes.
Machru bet knesset.
Yeah. Where you see machru bet knesset?
If
they sold the beit haknesset.
Mayim asfarim.
No, so they emptied it out. They took it out.
Where to put?
No. Machru beis haknesset. If let's say all the people moved out of the neighborhood, and there's nothing to do with the building, so then they sell the building.
Asur limkor bet knesset.
But if there's no people, but if there's no
neighborhood change,
there's no people there anymore. The people left.
The people left.
So now they take the money from the building to buy a new building in the new neighborhood.
New neighborhood.
Yeah?
And they also buy straw.
Dr. Smy, you had to leave Iran, right? So a lot of Jews left. So they have a building there. What are they going to do with it? So they sell the building. Wait a minute. They could sell the building and then in Yerushalayim build a new building.
Unfortunately.
Okay.
No.
They couldn't sell it. I know.
They couldn't sell
it. No. I know. But no, Doc. I'm just giving you an example. Where there are Jews in one place and they have to leave. So then what happens to the building?
I remember,
you remember
when I was a child.
Yes.
I remember the Bet Knesset in Iran.
Took it over.
Beautiful.
Yeah, I know.
They take it. Yeah. Like,
okay. Are they buying a new sfarim or are they using the sfarim from the building before?
Ad shemachru some, you can say there. Shemalim bekaidish, because you're always going up in Kedusha, you can't go down.
But the sfarim that are these new sfarim they're getting, or they're taking sfarim from the old shul?
Yes.
So that's what they're taking, right?
Right, and if they said the money from the sfarim, they could buy a safe attire with that money.
Okay.
Because the same idea as the Kedusha is when you mevatel the artsius, the physicality around it, that's the Kedusha. Shazel bechinas Kedusha Sefer Torah she'or haklaf, the skin, the parchment. Mechubar la'aisius is connected, is joined to the letters. Hakasa bechibor chazak li'aylam. When you take the letter, there's a piece of parchment, and the sofer writes on the Bereishis, Bar, Reli, Kim, and so he starts writing his Sefer Torah. Okay? So when he puts those letters on the parchment, they are connected to the parchment for eternity. Those letters are connected to that parchment. By days at, and it's Hapecha Klaf, Likedusha. And now the cloth, that was just a piece of parchment. Mm-hmm. It was just a piece of parchment. But now the piece of parchment takes on a new entity. It takes on a new level that now it has the kedusha of a sefer Torah, the highest level of kedusha. The kedusha gemura shel ha'oisis hakedushim b'sefer Torah, the holy letters and the spaces that are in between the letters, and that's how this came in over here with discussing the spaces, right? Ki ikka aliyas hakedusha hu ayidei adibur. The main point of aliyah of kedusha is through our dibur, through our speaking. We read the words of the Torah. We speak to Hashem as baydidus. Exactly. That's talking about the karbonis. But again, it's the same idea. Same idea. That's the letters of the Sefer Torah. You read from the Sefer Torah. We have a Balkayr over here, right? So you read from the Sefer Torah. That's the Ikka Kedusha that you read. You see the letters, you read from the Sefer Torah. Shehem, Oisis Adiba, those are the letters of the Dibur that you're reading, that you're enunciating, and that's what the speech is. Because now that the klaf, the parchment is connected with those letters, b'keshech chazak uba'achdus gadol kol kach, and the letters are absorbed into the parchment, and they're connected into the parchment eternally, right? Legabe oisis aksav v'koinim kedusha gemura, and they acquire for themselves a kedusha gemura, through what? The fact that the Sefer took the Diyoy, that special ink that was made with the special formula, and he wrote it the way Chazal taught him to write the letters on this parchment. It infuses it with this high level of Kedusha, that before it was just a regular piece of cloth. It was a piece of parchment. Baal Kain, HaSefer Torah V'Svarim Heim Mitzvahs Sheyesh Gufun Kedusha. So now you have Sefer Torah and Svarim, that they themselves, the goof of the thing itself, the body of the thing itself, of it is kedusha. Ki gufan kedusha machmas shemikushrin loisis. And why does it have the kedusha? Because it's connected to the letters. See, the same way we were learning before with the land. Why is the land under this building holy? Because it's connected to this building. You understand how it works?
Right.
The same way you have a piece of parchment. That's just a piece of parchment. Someone can write anything they want on it. Right? Parchment used to be something that people used to write. They didn't have paper. They wrote on parchment. Right? They wrote documents, contracts. They wrote letters to friends. They used to write. But here, he used it. He used this parchment to write a Sefer Torah. They used this land, it's just land. They could have made a playground over here, right? It could have been a house. It could have been an apartment building. It could have been a hotel. But no, it's a shul. So the same way the klaf, the piece of parchment, becomes kedusha, and it's infused in the kedusha. It's one with the kedusha because the letters were written on it. So too, in our example over here with the Beis HaKnesses, it was built on this land, so it becomes part and parcel with the land. So that's another proof, Yehuda, why that the land itself should now make its way to Eretz Yisrael and not just other land that it should be planted on. Maybe, okay? You like that? It's an idea, right?
I can take it.
You can take it. Okay, Val, okay.
Well, you think that the land in the foreign country that's attached to the base Hakanesses of that
it's built country. On the land. Built on the
so
land.
So that's also holy.
Yes, the land. That land that the shul is on, that's holy land. Yes.
Outside of Israel.
What?
Outside of Israel.
Yes, that's exactly the point. That land and that building that's being used by Jews to serve Hashem takes and it gets its kedusha from Yerushalayim, and it's holy. It has the kedusha of Eretz Yisrael in that building. Okay. Exactly. Fascinating, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Valkein Agashmi Shalem this Bata Legamri Legabe Akedusha. So the gashmias of the piece of parchment, it's not important anymore that it's parchment. You're not going to look at a Sefer Torah and say, oh, it's a nice piece of parchment. No, it's a Sefer Torah. It loses its status of being a piece of parchment, and it becomes now, it's elevated to become a Sefer Torah. It's the cloth of a Sefer Torah.
From the whole
perfect. Achiyev shalishan leitz kedusha until it's impossible to change the kedusha. You can't change it. Oyli oylem forever. Kemevoya bepaiskim shedava sheyesh begufay kedusha einay mishtan mikdushas oyli oylem. Something that has within itself its essence is kedusha. It can never ever be changed. It can't be changed. And the same thing with the Kiddush of a Yid, a Jew. A Jew is holy. We are born as holy people. We can't be changed. We are always holy. It's not changeable. Ki tashmishei kedusha bolu tzrichin geniza. Because tashmishei kedusha, if they get damaged, if they get worn out, you have to bury them.
Or they would put them away. They would secrete like the geniza in
geniza. Yeah, geniza. They would bury it, or they would put it in a cave, or they would put it away. Aval abeis hakneses afal pishem medabrim by diburim kedoshim shel Torah tefila. Abeis hakneses, even though you speak in the beis hakneses, the tefila and Torah in the beis hakneses, adayinu nikra tashmishei mitzvah kamuva bepaiskim. The beis hakneses is why it's still called part of tashmishei kedusha. So in other words, the Beis HaKnesses is similar to the Sefer Torah, but it's a little bit different too. Why? Because the Beis HaKnesses, if the representatives of the community make a determination and make a decision that this shul now, we can't stay here for whatever reason it is, it's dangerous for us to be here, for whatever reason, we have to move on. So they can actually remove the Kedusha. They can do that. Because he's saying that the Beis HaKnesses is actually part of Tashmishei Kedusha.
But there are limitations upon the use for each use for which they would sell it. You have to be careful.
Exactly. Ki ein ha-beis ha-knesses mekushe kol kach la-dibra kodesh k'may ha-klaf ba-oishes.
That's for sure.
Because the same way when you're reading from the klaf on the Sefer Torah. So the klaf itself, you're using the klaf itself to say the words, and that's where the Kedusha comes from. But the Beis HaKnesses, even though you're reading the Sefer Torah in the Beis HaKnesses, right? You're reading it in the shul, but you're reading it as not, it's a different type of a Kedusha. It's a different type of Kedusha. Okay. Tzarech Adam sheyekadesh atzmai kol kach bedibrei Torah tefila. Therefore, every person, every one of us, a Yidden, has to work very hard to be mekadesh ourselves through the dibra, the words of Torah and tefila. Achi is bata legabe. Hadibur legamer until we mavatel, we nullify ourselves to the dibur. Da'ina sheyia gufay mechuba v'kollo ba'adibur. We have to think. You know, when you read, right? When you're learning Torah, don't scan the words. Say the words. You read the words. You read it. You enjoy the words. You have to become part and parcel with the words. K'maya klaf ha'mechuba ba'isyos ad she'klaf ima'isyos heim dover echad mamish. The same way the klaf and the letters are one of the same, they become part and parcel to the same thing. So to us, when we read from it, we have to read with such a feeling that we become part and parcel to the letters. Ki shneim yachad heim sefer Torah. Until it's supposed to be ingrained in us. It's supposed to be chokuk. It's supposed to be engraved in us. But not let it be that any other letters, any other things become part and parcel of us, but rather we're supposed to make sure it's only the Torah that which stays with us for eternity is what's part of us. The same way the klaf of the Sefer Torah. Once you start writing the Sefer Torah on there, you're not going to use the klaf of the Sefer Torah to write anything else. You're not going to take that klaf and write any other notes on there. You make a shopping list. You're not going to do that on the klaf. So too, we're saying like this, we have to be part, we have to be like the Sefer Torah. That when we learn and we do things, make our tefillah and our Torah part of us, and all the other things that we know are just external, not part of us. Our other, you know, chitzonius knowledge that we have, the external knowledge that we have, it's not part of us. Torah and tefillah have to become part of us. And if we work on that, we as Yidden can have the same Kedusha. Every Jew can have the same Kedusha as the Sefer Torah. The same way the ink is infused into the lead, to the cloth of the Sefer Torah, and that's what gives it its level of Kedusha. So to us, if we read the words and we engrave it into us, we ingrain it into us, the letters, the words of Torah and Tefillah, we have this, we gain the same Kedusha as the Sefer Torah. Fascinating. This is Zayis HaTorah Adam. The Haine, Shadam Azeh Ba'atzmai, Hu HaTorah, Kamuva Zeh B'Divrei Rabbeinu Zal, Al HaTalmud Chacham Kazeh, Shamar B'Seinu Zal, Kama Tif Shoei, Shar Enoishi, the Kaimu Mekaimai, Sefer Torah, V'Loi Kaimu Mekaimai Tzeruva, Mirabanan. Right, so we said that that's the Gemara in Makis. How wonderful is a person that he works on becoming like the Sefer Torah and not like something else. Write them, as it says in Mishlei, write it on the luach, the tablet of your heart. You should engrave and have it on your heart, the words of the Torah and the Tefillah. It should be so important to us, the same way it's on the Torah. So we learned a few different things. We learned about what does it mean that the Bati Knesias make their way to Eretz Yisrael, right? And because the Artsius is Mevatel, and then the Mele, the Beis HaKnesses, makes its way to Eretz Yisrael. And we're saying that the Kedusha of the land, all right, the land that under the Beis HaKnesses is holy because the Beis HaKnesses is connected to it. However, there's one difference. The Beis HaKnesses can be changed, is different than the Sefer Torah, because the Sefer Torah can never be changed. You can't remove the letters from the cloth. It's attached to the cloth, right? And therefore, the Sefer Torah can never lose its status of a Sefer Torah. We're sure, though, if it's determined by the elders of the community that for some reason the shul has to be sold, so then they will then infuse the money, the funds that the building was sold with, they have the Kedusha, and when they use the money to buy a next building, the next shul, the next Sefer Torah, the money will be, the Kedusha will be transferred to that thing. But we're supposed to be not like the shul that can be changed. We're supposed to be like the Sefer Torah. That we're supposed to work constantly and engrave and ingrain ourselves with the words of Torah and Tefillah. And by doing that, it'll be aluach libecha, it'll be on our hearts, and in Mitzvah Hashem, we should work on doing this our entire lives, and we should have a beautiful Lech Lecha Shabbos. Oh, we'll take our break now.
Still making tea. It's almost done.